What's up, YouTubers? So before we get started with this video, on First Take, they're going to be talking about what should we think about Bill Belichick now that Tom Brady has won his 7th Super Bowl. So let's see what they have to say about that.
We don't have 1,000 seasons to play out, to run perfect experiments, to see who was who. This is pretty much as good as you could ask for. Brady's on a new team, Belichick's coaching without him. And by the way, if anything, the coach has the advantage because when the coach is older, he should still be good. Brady's 43.
Yeah, but the coach doesn't apply what they're learning. Like, Tom Brady applies what he learned or what he schemed with Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick can't play.
So the answer, does this affect Belichick's legacy? The answer is yes. He has to now win without Brady. He can't just, oh, that's a good coaching job. He went 8-8 this season. Nope. He's got to make deep playoff runs. He should win a ring without Brady before all is said and done. Or his legacy, the great debate, is it more Belichick or Brady? Shockingly to me, will be won by those who said, no, it was more Brady. Yes, this is a big deal. It's a big...
So definitely, I think we have to look at Bill Belichick, like what's going on, because Tom Brady was able to go to another team and go to the Super Bowl and win it his first year with another team. You got to be kidding me, man. You got to be kidding me. And Gronk's there too for New England Patriots? Yeah, we're definitely going to look at Bill Belichick like, you know, is it you or Tom Brady? And at this point, you can see that all those victories were with Tom Brady. In actuality, I mean, it's not really that hard of an argument because Tom Brady is the one who goes out there and applies whatever he learned or whatever schemes they draw up from Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick's just a coach, so he's dependent on whoever his quarterback is and the rest of his team. So it's kind of an easy debate, but now it's more clear.
Deal, but... not for Bill Belichick, the coach. I have no questions about Bill Belichick, the coach, because in the sport of football, it takes more than just a quarterback to win it, as we learned last night. Mm-hmm. You consider what happened on defense, you consider what happened on special teams, and you have an overseer that allocates responsibility to the people he picks to put in charge, you know, whether it's offensive coordinator, defensive line coach, linebackers coach, quarterback coach, et cetera, et cetera. You're the head coach, you oversee all of that, and Bill Belichick is a 6-time champion as a head coach, a 2-time champion as a coordinator, a guy that's been to 11 Super Bowls in his career. I refuse to insult that man by questioning the coach that is Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick, the GM, however, is an entirely different conversation. You could have had DK Metcalf or A.J. Brown instead of somebody like a...
N'Keal Harry.
Like N'Keal Harry. You could have had a Damian Harris, for example, who's been impressive, instead of a Sony Michel who can ball. I'm not trying to knock Sony Michel. When you look at the quarterback position, forget the Jimmy Garoppolo deal, because we understand that. I'm sorry, I think Jacoby Brissett at this point in time in his career is better than Cam Newton. You could have still had him, somebody.
I don't know if I agree with that.
Who was better, younger, the fresher legs, not beaten up, age and attrition hadn't kicked in, and on top of it all, he was familiar with the New England system. All of those things come into play. And when you don't have those things at your disposal because you've made a decision as a GM, that is bad enough. But when it gets incredibly egregious, y'all, is when, as I reported and I told you last year, Tom Brady would have stayed if he believed he was wanted by Bill Belichick. Owner Robert Kraft would have found a way to make it happen. If Bill Belichick has shown enough respect and enough affection for Tom Brady to let him know you're wanted, you're valued. But that was not the case. So Tom Brady was hell-bent on going elsewhere to prove what his value was. And when you listen to these guys on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers speak about Tom Brady, it's not just guys on the offensive side of the ball. It wasn't just Leonard Fournette. It wasn't just Antonio Brown. You talk about Shaq Barrett. You talk about Devin White and others. You talk about Ndamukong Suh, who was interviewed by Greeny this morning on Get Up. And you see, you talk about the coach that is Bruce Arians. And you hear everybody collectively speak about the leadership ability of this dude and how he galvanizes everybody. What you have is a coach who's also the GM in New England that selectively decided to ignore that component. In other words, this is my program. We're going to do it my way. The hell with all of that. And when you do that to somebody that old who's produced for you and somehow you missed you miss the leadership component that he brings to the team and how he's able to squeeze out whatever somebody else has left in them. Then you think about Gronk, who wanted to retire and was shivering on stage one day talking about, you have no idea what I was going through. But now not only does he come back, shines in the Super Bowl, but says he ain't thinking about retiring.
Yep.
They look like they're
having
fun.
Brady, the GM, is pretty darn good too.
Yeah, so that's definitely, Bill Belichick has to be kicking himself from, you know, he was sitting at home watching Tom Brady, you know, take care of business in a Super Bowl again. He's got to be kicking himself because all because of his ego, he couldn't tell the guy that he worked with for 20 years and won 6 Super Bowls with. He couldn't tell him, look, you think maybe you can come back and we can run this back and, you know, go for another Super Bowl run, maybe even win another Super Bowl? All because of his ego. He's lost out on another Super Bowl, and now he has to prove himself to see if he can win without a Tom Brady, which is going to be very, very hard to do in a near future.
He brought back Leonard Fournette, all these players. All 31 points that were scored by the Bucs guys were all players that were not on the Bucs in 2019 who went 7-9. They all came